Somerset Berkley Regional School Committee to order at 6:45. Do notice having been posted. I'd like to advise the members of the public that the open session part of this meeting will be electronically recorded, and if anyone in the audience also wishes to electronically record the open session part of the meeting, you should request permission from the committee at this point. Roll call. Mr. Kelly?
Here.
Mr. Ghilarducci?
Here.
Mr. Gagliardi?
Here.
Camara?
Here.
Mr. Rothwell?
Here.
Ms. White informed us just a short time ago that she's not feeling well and not being at the meeting tonight. Also with us tonight is Superintendent Thomas Lynch, Superintendent Peirce, Somerset School District, Recording Secretary. So, that's it. So, I'm going to stand for a couple of minutes. Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. First item on the agenda is to enter into executive session to conduct a collective bargaining session and to discuss strategy with respect to collective bargaining or litigation because an open meeting may have a detrimental effect on the bargaining or litigating position of the committee. I'd entertain a motion to that effect.
So moved.
Second. Motion made by Mr. Camara and seconded by Mrs. Gagliardi. Any discussion? Absent discussion, roll call, Mr. Kelly.
Aye.
Mr. Ghilarducci.
Aye.
Mrs. Gagliardi.
Aye.
Aye. Mr. Rothwell. The chair votes aye. And since we're entering into executive session, I will ask the members of the public to leave the room at this point. All right. Returning to open session, the first item on the agenda is consider acceptance of the Secretary's report of open session 1 and 2 minutes of June 27, 2013. Can I have a motion?
So moved. Second.
Motion made by Mrs. Gagliardi and seconded by Mrs. Rothwell. Any discussion? In the absence of discussion, all is in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous.
I'll abstain.
All right, unanimous, except that Mr. Camara abstains.
Mr. President.
Thank you.
Mr. Ghilarducci was also absent, so we still have a majority of the committee present, so the chair votes aye as well. The minutes are adopted. Next item, consider acceptance of the Secretary's report of executive session minutes of June 27th, 2013.
So moved.
Second. Okay, motion made by Mrs. Gagliardi and seconded by Mrs. Rothwell. Any discussion? In the absence of discussion, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Abstentions?
Abstain.
Okay, and the chair votes aye. Four in favor, none opposed, two abstentions. Is there any public input? Okay, in the absence of public input, last month I circulated a tentative schedule of meetings, scheduling meetings on Mondays. I didn't want to go through the entire schedule tonight, but I did want to see if we could establish the schedule for July and August. The proposed, there's a proposed date for July of July 22nd, which is a Monday. And the proposed August meetings are August 5th and August 19th.
I may not be here for August 5th, but I will be here for August 19th.
I may not be here for August 5th, but I can make the 19th.
You can?
Can make the 19th, but the 5th I may
be. I cannot make the 19th, but I could make the 5th.
All right, well, I think we're going to run into those issues in the summertime, so
If there's no objection, is there objection to scheduling the meetings on those dates?
No. Only July 22 is my 46th wedding anniversary, so I won't be here.
All right. Will you be able to attend, Mr. Kelly? Because we do need
yes.
a quorum.
Okay.
But the other issue is that, which is also on the agenda, I believe. Well, it falls under this item. There was some preliminary discussion about having a joint meeting with the Somerset School Committee on July 23rd, which is the date of their only meeting in July. One reason would be to hear a report from Whitson's Food Service. Mm-hmm. And the second purpose was to discuss the possibility of discussing any personnel issues which may require a joint decision by both committees. I realize it's two nights in a row, but the members of the Somerset Committee would be attending both meetings anyway. So would the committee be open to a joint meeting on the 23rd if it's necessary?
Yes.
Thank you.
All right, the next item is a possible date for a session / workshop for goal setting for the upcoming year. We have talked about trying to do this at the beginning of the year in the past. We haven't been successful. We talked about the possibility of doing it jointly with the Somerset Committee, and I think we could certainly be open to that, but I think that we should try to set a date when we could try to set goals for the committee or objectives for the coming year. Does anyone else have any thoughts about that?
Would that, do you know the agenda is going to be on the 20th? If we're having a meeting on the 23rd, a joint meeting, is there any room on the 22nd to do that? Or you're talking about a separate?
I was hoping that we could have a meeting that was focused pretty much entirely on...
like a business meeting style?
Goal setting.
A workshop style.
A workshop. Yeah, that would be a good workshop. Would we have a different, an outside facilitator, or would we do it ourselves? We talked about...
I think the idea of facilitator was a kind of an approach to different kinds of issues.
Okay. So, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, Michelle, but I think our meeting on the 23rd is going to be kind of packed anyways. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think it'll be important for us to be able to do the joint meeting, particularly about Whitson's. I don't know. I don't think we'd have time for something like that. So you're suggesting a different date for a potential working meeting with both committees? Or is this strictly regional?
I was thinking the meeting of the regional committee.
Okay. Okay.
But to clarify, it's not just Whitson on the 23rd. We also want to see if we can enter into discussions about the shared positions.
Correct.
So when we work on our agenda, we'll have to take that into consideration.
Yeah.
Because that would be a priority issue.
I did a draft already, but
so we would look to try to do it in the summer, if at all possible, or early fall at the very latest, to do the goal setting. Because it'll be goals for the upcoming year.
Yes. I would hope we could do it before the end of August.
I think that would be optimal before the school starts. Yes.
Usually, if I could, Mr. Ghilarducci could attest to this. We usually, in Berkeley, I have always presented goals to the committee in August, and then they have, we have discussed them and with any comments, and then in September, we would vote on them, they would vote on them. Last year, they were a little different because of the new teacher evaluation process, because the superintendent would have goals, and embedded in those goals would be district goals as well. So we could approach that a number of ways.
When do you think you'd be able to present goals?
Whenever you'd like me to.
By
August
5th?
Do that 5th or the 19th, 5th would be fine.
Okay. Can we do that in Berkeley in air conditions?
Absolutely.
Okay.
If those of us who can't make it, we can get them forwarded to us.
Sure.
When?
And if anyone has any suggestions prior to that,
okay,
for a district goal, you can forward them to me, and maybe Mr. Peirce and I could look at those and come up with two or three. I think it's important to have a reasonable amount of goals rather than have, you could easily have 10 or 12 goals,
mm-hmm,
but some goals are understood.
Right.
That we have every single year, so they're ongoing goals. But you want to have a couple of measured goals that we can really, really measure throughout the course of the year if we're making progress to satisfy those goals.
I think that's reasonable. The only piece that I would look forward to is the dialogue or the brainstorming amongst the committee to kind of see where we all, how we all feel about those goals. So maybe as part of that, even though you try to look,
absolutely,
at our suggestions and call,
sure,
them out, maybe there could be some discussion of these were the total goals that we had.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So that we can,
absolutely,
summarize them. Yeah.
I mean,
but so that we can kind of see that, well, maybe the ones that I submitted and Rothwell submitted were similar, but
right,
let's
you may be able to combine
this,
two goals,
yeah,
into us.
So that we can kind of see where the consensus was.
Right. Absolutely.
And that sets up the perfect thing that if we start the goals on August 5th, as I said, I think then by October or November at the latest, what we can do is we can begin evaluating the superintendent. Because at that point, we're looking at the goals and how we're moving toward the goals and what's happening with the goals. And that would be the evaluation that we can do. So that way, we don't wait until we're well into the year, but like do a 3-month evaluation, then a 6-month evaluation, and then the annual evaluation.
Well, under the new teacher evaluation or educator evaluation that the DESC provided to districts last year.
Mm-hmm.
The superintendents as well as the teachers, but administrators have a mid-cycle review. And I suggest we do that, as Mr. Ghilarducci said, somewhere around November or December. And then the final evaluation, the summative evaluation, if you will, prior to May, before possible new members come on, so that, for instance, the 6-7 members of this committee will know what I've done as far as working here and as far as the goals go. But if we were to have that in May or June, we may have 2 new members or more that may have really don't have any experience with me at all. So I think it would be more legitimate and more fair to have the mid-cycle review somewhere around late November or early December, and then the summative evaluation towards the end of April.
So are we going to follow up then with second part of that goals workshop on August 19th? Would you say it's doing that as part of that meeting, or do you want to?
Yes, and in that way everyone will have had an opportunity to have input.
So you would need our goals to be submitted to you by what time?
I would hopefully in the next 2 or 3 weeks,
okay,
at least a week prior to the 5th.
Okay. All right. So the next item is personnel issues, and that item was simply intended
to get an update if there has been any progress on any of the issues that we discussed at the last meeting. I know that there really hasn't been any progress, as far as I know, about scheduling a meeting between the chairs, co-chairs, and superintendents. My understanding was we were waiting to hear back.
We were waiting to hear back from all members could make it, or all participants could make it today at 3:30, except Mr. Rebello is unable to make it.
So we should try
we still need to try, we still need to schedule that meeting.
And we should try to do it before the 23rd, I think.
Yes.
So if we can, and I'm not sure if Mr. Medeiros is going to be away. Is it next week?
He is. I spoke to him.
Okay,
prior
so
to
both
the
you
meeting.
And Mr. Medeiros are going to be away all of next week at the superintendent's, the annual superintendent's conference.
From the 16th, Tuesday through Friday.
So we should try to schedule something this week if we possibly can.
Right.
Mr. Rebello, I believe, is out of the country this week.
17th. Until the 17th.
17th, yeah.
And that's
next.
That's next Thursday.
Yeah, okay. Do you want to try to shoot for the 22nd, the same time that we were thinking about today, 3:30?
I can do that. It's fine with me.
Okay, I was going to suggest, I don't know if you want to entertain this or not, in regards to the personnel issues, is the formation sort of a subcommittee made up of a representative from Berkeley K-8, Somerset K-8, and the region, to look into the issues in regards to whether to have one superintendent for all three regions, one district manager, one special education. Since a lot of we have an interim superintendent, we have no special education director, I think it'd be a good time if we discuss that with the Somerset K-8, Berkeley K-8, and the region, as to whether we have one person in charge of all the directors' administration of all three regions. I think it might be a good time to explore that. And if you have a subcommittee from someone made up of the Somerset K-8, Berkeley K-8, and the region to explore that, I think it's probably a good time to do that as we work through all these issues.
Well, I will raise that at our meeting, at our meeting of chairs, and see whether there's interest on the part of Somerset K-8. District at this point to consider that.
Even if it's going on, even if it's just a committee that looks at what those options might be and how, just investigative. We're going to have this committee, this chairs and vice chairs, a meeting to resolve some issues for the upcoming school year and pending positions that are still not resolved. But this would be kind of a committee that looks towards the future to see how that could be developed, if it makes sense, and how it could be put in place. Is that what you're thinking?
Yeah, because if you look at it right now,
we
have an interim superintendent, that's superintendent of Berkeley K-3 and the region, who's up next year. We don't have a special education director. One of the options may be that the region hires the Berkeley K-3 director and the Somerset stays with the Mr. Murray for another year, and then we have to decide what to do with that. We have the director of business, I think, contracts up next year. We have the director of curriculum. So there's a lot of decisions that need to be made this year as to what the structure is going to be going forward for the next 5-6 years. And I think this is a good time to explore that. We also have the Somerset K-3 worried about percentages of what the directors make and what the portion of the region is towards the K-3 in the region. And if you bring in Berkeley, they could participate in what percentages. So I think it's a good opportunity this time to look more globally about what the structure will be in the next 5 or 6 years, when we have an opportunity now, because a lot of the positions are in flux. And you can get an idea, you can speak to the directors now, the interim superintendent, Superintendent Medeiros, to get their ideas involved, as well as the people in place here, and see if that's something that can work or not. But I mean, it's gonna take some time and some consideration to do that. So if you have a subcommittee set up, I think it's a way to go, and that may influence on how we structure this year as to look for future for the next 5-6 years. I just thought it was an idea.
Part of those discussions will take place when the chair and the vice chair of each committee meet with the superintendents. Mr. Medeiros and I have already had preliminary discussions regarding the special needs director, regarding the technology director, in which direction to go with those. There are, as I see it, there are three options right now to go with a special, on how to go with a special needs director. One would be to have Mr. Murray be the interim special ed director for the year for the region and for Somerset K-8. One would be to have, and she is willing to do this, is to appoint Kathy Bolio, who is the coordinator and is certified as a special needs director, to give her the position. She is agreeable to that. Melissa Donnelly, the special ed director in Berkeley, is a third option. She would, of course, need permission to do that, as I got it from the Berkeley School Committee. But she is willing to be a mentor to Kathy Bolio as far as outside placements, as far as transportation, and any issues that Mrs. Bolio would need. I did speak with Mr. Necres and Mr. Medeiros about his position. I do need to follow up with a discussion with Mr. Medeiros about that. There are two options to go there as well. And we do need to have a discussion, and again, from this list, many of these are scheduled to be discussed with the two chairs and the two superintendents. The director of fine arts and music is another position that needs to be discussed.
Yeah, my thoughts are, I mean, we can do one or two things. We can do a patchwork this year with the idea, if say the subcommittee comes back and says, yeah, the Somerset K-8 is enthusiastic about administration for all three regions, the region thinks it's fine, and that the Berkeley K-8 is enthusiastic about it as well. I mean, I think you may go in a different direction this year than if the Somerset K-8 says, no, I think we're better off if we, you know, do it a different direction. I just think it should be explored as we develop this interim year here and then the next 5 or 6 years down the road. That should be part of the conversation as to whether we want one administration for all three regions.
The only concern I have is that I wouldn't want us to hold up some of these positions that have been held up for already a good amount of time.
We have to move on.
Right.
Yeah.
Yesterday.
Sooner than late.
Right.
Yes.
And so that's why hopefully we'll be able to have some preliminary discussions as soon as we're able to schedule this meeting. So the next item is year-end budget and financial issues or transfers, and the Director of Business and Finance is not present. I see a list of items here included in our packet, but
Mr. Furtado gave it to me, Mr. Medeiros to give to you.
Oh, all right. So
can I do one thing under old business before we go? I came back, I'm sorry I missed last meeting, but what I did do is I did go to get some information, which I think you would be interested in. 74 of the 108 students who graduated from Berkeley Middle School will be attending Somerset High School. 36 out of 108 students had a 3.5 grade average or above over her 4 years in Berkeley. And Caitlin Capello, who was one of our top 10 in Somerset High School, was the recipient of a $5,000 scholarship from the Berkeley Scholarship Committee. That's the top award. And she's going to UNH. And then Kim also, the principal of the middle school, told me shadow days are occurring right now with Berkeley students in Somerset under the auspices of Ann Nassif. So she's doing peer buddies. The kids from Berkeley are coming here, and she's providing them with peer buddies to introduce them into Somerset. So that's going very, very well.
Okay.
Thank you for that information.
You're welcome.
So I'm assuming there's no action on this memorandum.
You don't have any clarification on that, Mr. Lynch?
No, Mr. Fattah has not given me any information on that.
So there were just a couple of other items that I wanted to mention. One just came to my attention today, so it's an item that will fall under the fact that it just came to our attention. Mr. Fenstermaker asked us, and of course he's the chair of the building committee, that we need to formally authorize Mr. Lynch to serve as the executive to sign any MSBA documents, and that we need to designate David Patrick to replace Richard Ruggiero on the building committee. So could I have a motion to that effect?
So what would you
want to do those two separate motions or the same?
Well, if there's we can do them the same unless anyone feels that they want to handle them separately. We'll do it separately, just because it's important, I believe, that we have a separate vote in terms of authorizing Mr. Lynch to act. So why don't I entertain that motion first?
So moved.
All right.
Second.
Motion made by Mrs. Gagliardi and seconded by Mr. Camara. Any further discussion? In the absence of discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. And the second issue is to appoint David Patrick to serve on the building committee in the place of Richard Ruggiero, who submitted a letter of resignation from the committee.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Mr. Camara and seconded by Mrs. Gagliardi. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. And the only other issue that I wanted to bring to the committee's attention, this is a matter that's sort of languished. When I was at the school committee conference in last November, one of the, hesitate to call them vendors, but one of the exhibitors was a former superintendent who is the representative of Educadius, which is an organization that arranges for foreign students to attend 1 year of high school in the United States. Students come from around the world, and it seems to me as something that we should at least investigate, in the sense that the students pay tuition to attend the school for a year. And it also, I think, enriches the student body to have students from Europe or from the Far East as possible students at our high school. And so I wanted to ask the superintendent to just investigate this and report back to us as to whether it was something that we might pursue further, but I didn't want to ask him to do that without at least letting the committee know about this. So. Is there any objection to the superintendent at least looking into the feasibility? There are several high schools in Massachusetts, that public high schools, that already participate in the program. Burlington High School, Groton Dunstable Regional High School, Hopkinton, Marblehead, Massacomonomet Regional High School in Topsfield, Massachusetts, Medfield, Natick, Mohawk Trail Regional High School in Shelburne Falls, North Brookfield, Norset Regional High School, Rockport, Pawtucket Regional.
I don't have any objections, but we don't have foreign exchange students currently in the district?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay.
I'll be happy to speak to some of the superintendents.
Two this year?
There was one from Thailand.
Yeah, I did a story on one.
Well, he's going to be at the superintendent's meeting, so.
All right, so I'll provide this material. Mr. Lynch.
Should we be considering signing up for the conference to that? Is that?
Oh, yes, that was the other point that I wanted to raise.
On November?
The school committee conference is November 6th through 9th, Wednesday the 6th through Saturday the 9th. There is a substantial savings, about $100 in the registration fee, if someone registers by July 15th. So if anyone is interested in attending the conference and is able to make a decision about it before July 15th, Michelle, do you usually?
I can register. I've registered 50 Michelle already in the Somerset side.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Ghilarducci.
I'll go.
For the whole conference?
I'll be attending as well. I just need to get the dates too, but I think this year I'll be able to attend. From at least from Thursday on.
There should be one person nominated to go to the delegation and vote.
We haven't got, usually when it gets close, we get a form in.
Yeah.
And then I put it on the agenda for you to designate someone.
I would like to attend, but there's a conference in New Orleans that I've attended in the past that's the same days, and I'm torn as to which I'm going to attend, so I don't know if I can commit by the 15th, but we'll see. I have attended in the past 2 years. All right, is there any other business?
I just wanted to thank AI3 and everyone involved for the tour on Saturday of the construction project. It was a good opportunity for us to kind of just walk through the space and see the progress of our guys.
We should thank our spectator on the SATV9 and cable and the Herald News for covering it. They gave us some great information to the public regarding the progress on the project so far. So we appreciate that.
All right, I will entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Mr. Camara and seconded by Mrs. Gagliardi. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Unanimous. Thank you.